Hey y'all, my name's Priscilla and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you about a book that I recently read and that I really enjoyed. And that book is What It Means When a Man Falls from the Sky by Leslie Nneka Arima. And this is a debut collection of 12 short stories from an author that was raised mostly in Nigeria and lived a little bit in the UK and now resides in the US. And she writes mostly literary and speculative fiction that takes place in either Nigeria or the US, primarily from Nigerian or Nigerian American perspectives. And this is a very promising and very thought-provoking debut collection of short stories. This was so great, and I just wanna kinda talk about some of my favorite stories and why I enjoyed some of these stories so much with you. Leslie Nneka Arima has officially arrived in showing and being able to flex some of her literary skills and abilities in this collection. In a recent NPR interview, Leslie Nneka Arima was quoted as saying that she thinks that we're all doomed, and she very much writes realized, imagined futures of what that future may look like if we are doomed. Really enjoy her stories. Most of them are from the perspective of women, but I really enjoy her stories that are told from the perspective of very unlikable and complex and difficult women. And I do use difficult women on purpose because Roxane Gay absolutely loved this collection of short stories. And I think that if you liked Roxane Gay's collection of difficult women, that you would definitely like this collection as well. And in the first story, she really sets the tone for the rest of her other stories. The first story is titled The Future Looks Good, and I really think that that title is appropriate because it really gives a peek of what is yet to come. And in the story, we start with a woman that is at her front door and is about to unlock it, and as she's unlocking it, it sort of goes back and tells of what is behind her in her past and in her history that is leading up to this moment. And it's fragmented scenes of histories with her mother and father, and with her very troubled and very beautiful sister and her abusive husband. And the end of this short story really shocked me. It's such a powerful ending, that last line. Whew. I realized upon finishing it that Arima played me like a fiddle. Like, she had me hook, line, and sinker, and just had me hungry for what more she has to offer. I think that what she did so great in this story was she's able to use a dreamlike prose to emphasize the very quiet but very emotional moments that are happening with this main character and her family. And the next story I want to talk about is a very jarring read called Windfalls. And this is about a mother and daughter relationship. A very horrendous mother and a very obedient daughter. And in this story, the mother has got it down to a science, almost to an art form, in that she stages intentional falls and slips, and she then goes on to commit insurance fraud, and she sues the people for money. And they're sort of on the run, and they really live fall to fall to fall, money, paycheck to paycheck to paycheck. And in this story, the daughter starts a story describing how she has been pushed and she has fallen so many times from such a young age that now she is complicit in these acts. And I think that says a lot about the place of young girls in the world and how we're constantly pushed down so much that we end up just going along with it and going with the motions. And it's really a provocative look into the life of a mother and daughter and how their relationship is very intentionally gross and disgusting and disturbing. I have, of course, left the titular story for last. This was a story that I loved. I loved so much. It was so good. It's such a multi-layered, thought-provoking, beautifully written story, a speculative fiction work that took my breath away. It left me in a state of awe, in a state of wonder. In this story particularly, it takes place in a not-so-far-away near future in Nigeria, in a world that has been havoc, that has undergone intense climate change events that have caused mass flooding. most of the world is actually underwater, and the only surviving lands are Africa and Australia. So many of the refugees that are from these other countries that are now underwater have fled to Africa and Australia because these are the only lands that are available to live on. In this world, there's also this formula that has been discovered. And this formula is an infinite formula that supposedly explains the universe. And from this formula, mathematicians have been able to extract portions and are able to manipulate human beings. For instance, manipulate them to be able to fly. And our main character in this story is a very unlikable woman. She's one of these mathematicians that is able to use this formula in her daily work. And her work as a grief worker is to extract grief from people, extract and consume it herself. Some of the toughest clients are of refugees that have such grief and pain that is incomprehensible for her, that she actually picks clients that aren't refugees. In the story, there's also a mention of how this revelation of this formula has people thinking that this calculation is God. And I love it when stories are able to so wonderfully incorporate the ability of science and religion and God to exist together. In this world, because a man has fallen from the sky, there's also this question of if this equation is supposed to be God, then what does that say if he's falling from the sky? Maybe this formula isn't as perfect as everyone says. Maybe it's not reliable. What does that say about the existence of God and science? Maybe more questions than answers, but I'm okay with that because it was that good. So there's a lot to unpack in that story. I highly recommend that you read the entire collection for that story alone, if anything. Now, to be fair, in this review, I will talk a little bit about some cons. And I think with any short story collection, some stories are going to be stronger than others. Arima is able to really tell great speculative fiction stories, but I think that her literary fiction works are a bit weaker. But with that said, I mean, it's the difference between a very good story and a very good story. You know what I mean? Just a little bit more emphasis on the very. In conclusion, this is a very great collection of stories from a debut author, and I will definitely be looking out for anything that this author has to offer in the future. So I highly recommend this story. I think I'm gonna give it somewhere between 4 and 5 star as a read for me. Highly recommend it. Please go read it. I think everyone can find something in this story collection that they like. I'm not sure if I've mentioned this before, but I always leave links to my Goodreads and Twitter in the description. Please add me if you want to be friends. I accept all friend requests, and I'm always looking to be friends with people that enjoy reading and want to talk about reading. That's all I have to say about this book review. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye!